You've got two easy notes.
So the solitary confinement cells, where they used to house people before they were executed. And this is the walk that they would do to go and get executed.
Execution, there'd be 12 witnesses in this area appointed by the government of the day, including the superintendent and the prison chaplain. The surgeon would be down at the foot of the pit, hanging in the corner. The four officers would escort the condemned person from solitary confinement. Before they came out through that last gate, they would stop, lower the face mask over his eyes so he couldn't see. Of course, this barricade wasn't here when this was a working gallows. It had been put there to stop little girls from falling down the hole and having their parents sue us. The officers would escort the condemned person in, standing on the trapdoor, facing the witnesses right next to the noose, and they'd strap his ankles together. The chair was always out on the trapdoor in case the person couldn't stand and had to sit, but no record was ever being used in the 44 executions that took place here.
Well, we got let out of prison. And this is Perth. It's a lovely sunny Friday. We've come for a walk in King's Park, which is, we've just driven around and it's massive. Some of the wildflowers. This is Kangaroo Paw. This is a small boab tree. We saw much bigger ones than these just as we entered Western Australia, and we've seen a few that are so wide that they used to use them as prison cells. Weird. All these birds are in the Warren National Park, which is where we stayed last night for free in this campsite. And all around are these huge
carry trees. And we're going to go and try and find one called the bicentennial tree, which apparently you can climb up. Well, this is it. And it looks very high.
That's it for me.
Deb's off.
That's hard work, eh?
60 foot.
We haven't done it for a while. We haven't done it, period.
I think there's one lad coming up. Oh no, yeah.
This is just the first level.
Obviously, I haven't counted how many people up here.
Up to the first platform at the top, or the second platform at the top. Onwards.
We're rested. I'll never worry about going on the roof again. Oh, I'm glad I didn't put my shorts on. My little dress.
We're at the very top. That's a person down there. Do you reckon he's 69 metres high?
That's what the graffiti says. When have you ever known graffiti to be wrong?
It's swaying up here as well. Hold on, Deb.
It's only swaying a couple of feet.
What, can it sway up to a metre and a half?
Yep. Okay, going down. We've found some good fun frogs to play with here. Watch this. Only do it once. Try the one on the other side.
This one.
That's excellent.
We've come to the Valley of the Giants walk near Walpole, which is on the south west coast of Australia, and it's raining and it's cold, and this is like a treetop walk that takes you round the top of the tingle trees, giant tingle trees. Definitely see it wobbling.
It's wobbling quite a lot.
That's quite high. It's swaying away.
Huh?
Swaying away.
Job to spend it.
Thank you. nothing too close.
This is what I call a real ant.
How big is that?
Hey!
You're not having my finger.
There's another one up here.
Oh, I like the way it looks. It's like, whoa, what is that? Whoa. He's big too. This big.
We're on the air highway, just crossing the Nullarbor. It was tucking into an icy pole.
It's gone!
It's the only thing keeping us going. And we've got the next 3 or 4 days looking at this.
Woo-hoo.
This part of the air highway is a straight road for 145 kilometres, which is the longest and perhaps the most boring stretch of straight road in the world. So, thought we'd just show you for a couple of minutes what it's like. Boring, eh, Deb?
Sorry?
Do try and keep away. So, this is it for the next 4 days. What does Nullarbor mean?
No trees.
It's bad Latin for no trees. We've stopped at Eucla and we've come down towards the beach, which is on the Great Australian Bight, and these are the ruins of the old telegraph station. And they're set in the middle of this sort of desert of white dunes. And the birds you can hear are galahs. We're quite lucky to see this much of the ruins of the telegraph station, because our book says that you can normally just see this chimney sticking out of the dunes. Every now and again the dunes shift and you get to see a bit more. One of the bigger sand dunes. I'm sinking. It's lovely sand. Of emus just crossed our path. I've been on safari. Mm-hmm. Debbie's going down with a loaf of bread. To the southern bight, is that what it's called, Deb?
I think so. Yeah. Like that.
And we've seen a few whales while we've been here, but none this close. They're just out here, and there's a whole load of them. There's one there.
Oh, that one.
There's another one there. One over here too. They're amazing, they're so near.
Look, it's one on the left, quick.
Is that a mother and a calf,
I think,
do you reckon?
It probably is, yeah.
These are southern right whales. We've just had to pay $11 to come down here and we weren't sure what we were going to see. Amazing. That's how close we are. You can see the tail of the calf, can't you? Ah, you can see the white underneath them. There's the tail. the cough behind.
On Wednesday there was around about 30. Yeah, there's one here, there's an albino one here.
Oh yeah.
There's an albino. He must be went back that way somewhere.
Yeah. Jeez. Pumper gill. So sea whales.
Hello. How are you?
He's not going to say anything while he's on camera.
Hello. How are you today? Hello.
Bye.
Hello. Hello.
Bye.
How are you today?
See you later.
Hello. How are you today? Gone all shy. Hello.
Hello. How are you today? Bye.
Bye-bye.
See you later.
We're on our way down to the Great Ocean Road. We just stopped at this. It's going to become a salt pan, but it's a real pink lake at the moment. Strange. We're on the Great Ocean Road proper. It's very wet and cold and windy. And this is the Bay of Islands. I think we're going to go and get out of the rain now. It's bucketing down suddenly. These are the 12 apostles. It's very windy. Bell's Beach, where Point Break was filmed. on to Sovereign Hill. Met up with John and Ali. We're a couple of hours north of Melbourne now. We've come to have a look around Sovereign Hill.
Are you having a soft straw as well? Can you just order two?
No. Just one. Yeah. Oh.
Just one.
Yeah.
Sorry. Okay.
You can take two.
Gotta get used to the language diving here.
Yeah.
Says one at a time, please.
Oh, what's it really say?
Oh, look at that.
£143.
Oh, my word. the damages. What's it say?
It's gone off the scale.
Oh, my word. 180. 180.
170.
Pretty big, Mark.
Too many sausage rolls.
bowling alley.
You can walk on that up until the thing in front side. To the black line.
That's your bit of a bowling on one side.
Strike!
Starbucks, you'd say you're invited.
That's when we realised you spelled your name wrong. Mistake.
I reckon she's found some.
I have, yeah. See it?
Yeah.
There's some more there.
You gonna make her fortune? Look what she's got on the back of her hand there.
Going to go and find the load.
You've
got film kind of stuff.
Yeah, I'll sort you that one. Started on our walk from Hall's Gap on the Wonderland circuit, climbing up to the pinnacles now. Come on, Deb.
I should have been in the weightlifting.
It's Hercules.
I've got to get a photo. Stay there.
I don't think I can hold it much longer.
Looking down over Hall's Gap. Made it to the pinnacle, high point of our walk. Very windy up here.
Fish. Chili.
Healthy, it's cholesterol free,
chili,
fat
tuna
free.
Fish.
Nice and healthy.
Won't stay around long, won't it? She's a bit spicy. Better than the usual bread I get. Thank you. Sure, it's not too bad. Mm. Some sweet corn as well. Sweet corn.
Oh my god!
This is a black-footed rock wallaby. We're in Zoomstein now. Just come down here to have a look at the kangaroos. Oh, is the dad gone? We've left John now and we're in Canberra. Come to have a look round the new Parliament House. We're going to go and get ourselves booked on a tour. This is the Great Hall. There's a conference on at the moment. And this is the second largest tapestry in the world.
We're coming now into the centre of the building. So you're starting to feel how large the building is now? Because we're not yet to halfway in the main section of the building. This is the Members' Hall, and it's reflecting Federation. You will see the Federation Star, that seven-pointed gold star that sits below the Union Jack on our flag.
This is one of 17 courtyards.
And it faces this side, and you can see this gentleman leaning over the desk in the grey t-shirt. He's leaning over Mr. Kim Beazley's side, and that's where he sits. I'll tell you a bit of a story. There's lots and lots and lots of traditions that we follow from the House of Commons in Great Britain. And of course, the House of Commons has been going for hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of years. One of the traditions that's thought to be held in the House of Commons in Great Britain is that they've always kept the government and the opposition more than two sword lengths apart from each other. That table is actually more than two sword lengths wide. So old PM and Mr. Beazley can't cross the table. Okay, I think we might just have enough seats, have we? Almost in. Fantastic. Well, everywhere we've been today, I've told you all about those things that have inspired the architects for the colours. What do you think about our very famous Australian red wines? I think that inspired them? It wasn't. I like to think that. No, it was the very tip of the eucalypt leaf, the very deep red tip of the eucalypt, the new growth of eucalypt.
Up on the roof now.
Big, isn't it?
It is, isn't it?
We're back in Sydney. We've travelled 24,000 kilometres, 14,500 miles in 4 months, and we're back where we started. It's coming down through Darling Harbour. Looks pretty much the same.
We're back at the bridge. Where's that opera house? They've lit it up for us.
No.
Down there somewhere.
Just down there. It's North Sydney. Where we're heading.
We've stood on top of that bridge. Corner into Watson Street, where it all started 4 months ago. Have they kept our parking space for us, Deb?
No.
Bugger.
So maybe we have to do another corner.
We're at the Sydney 2000 Paralympic Games. Just about to run the final of the 5,000 metres.
finish normally.
It's a free go.
Yeah, and you get a free chance to get one more point.
Looking forward.
Gold medals awarded to British Paralympians today. Cross Car Market, trying to sell our van. Got all their stuff out here. And there's not many people around. It's Sunday and we've already been here for 2 days. And it's very quiet. 2.5 days we've been here. Seems like longer. This is the competition. All of them are about $4,500-$5,000. As you can see, it's not exactly swarming with prospective buyers. There goes our van. We've just sold it. It's gone. That's the last time we're going to see it. We sold it for $7,900. Wave bye-bye. We've only got 2 days left in Australia now. We're packing up our big boxes, ready to go home. And it's worse than having to tidy your bedroom when you're a kid.
It's just like having to tidy your bedroom.
This is our lovely room in King's Cross with the crack dealer next door. Hello.